Okay, Google. Turn on the light.
Okay, turning on the light.
Hey, what's up everybody, Abhishek Ingurani, and today I'm going to show you how you can control your electronical appliances using your voice over the internet, and that too under a budget of $20. So let's get started. Okay, so we'll complete this whole project in just 4 simple steps.
Now, if you wish to come back at any time or skip ahead on the timeline to any of these steps, you can find the times for each of these steps in the description.
Okay, so with all that said, let's get into it and make a start with the first step, which is to install and configure the Blink app. So I have my Android phone, and the first thing I'll do is go to the Play Store and download the Blink app and install it.
Once it's installed, I'll open it and log in using Facebook. Now that I'm logged in, I'll click on New Project and give the project a name such as Home Automation. I'll select NodeMCU as the device and select connection type as Wi-Fi. And finally, I would hit Create. At this point, Blink will send an auth token to the email ID registered with my Facebook account. I'll use this auth token later to link the Blink app with the NodeMCU. Okay, now in the blank project, I'll add 4 buttons to control the 4 relays. So, to add a button, I'll simply click on the blank area and select button from the menu. Now, I'll click on the button and name it Relay 1. And select the pin as Digital Pin D3. Similarly, I'll add another button, drag it into position, click on it, and name it Relay 2. And I'll select its pin as Digital Pin D4. I'll add the third button, name it Relay 3, and select the pin as D5. And finally, for the fourth button, I'll name it Relay 4 and select the pin as D6.
So that concludes the first step. Once you have the Blink app all set up, it's time to move into the next step, which is setting up the Arduino IDE and the Blink libraries.
Okay, so now I'm here at my work desk with my PC powered on.
So first of all, I'll open up my email and copy the auth token from Blink's mail and paste it somewhere like in the notepad. We'll use this auth token later. The next thing I'll do is go to Arduino's website and download the Arduino IDE. Just choose your preferred operating system and hit download. I'll also put all the links in the description below. Alternatively, Windows users can also go to Windows Store, search for Arduino IDE, and download and install it from there itself. I cannot download it as I already have it installed in my system. Once the Arduino IDE is installed, I'll go to Blink's GitHub page. Again, links are available in the description. I'll scroll down and download the latest Blink library. As I already have it downloaded, I'll hit cancel. But you'll get something like this after you have downloaded it. I'll right-click it and extract the contents of the zip file. Now I'll open up the Arduino IDE, go to File, Preferences, and copy this path, and close the IDE. Then I'll open up this path. Now this is the directory where all the Arduino libraries are installed, and therefore I'll have to copy the newly downloaded Blink libraries into this folder. So first I'll copy the downloaded Blink libraries and paste them in the libraries folder. As I've already copied them in my directory, I won't copy them again. So similarly, copy the Blink tools and paste them in the tools folder.
Alright, now I'll connect the NodeMCU to the PC.
Okay, so now that we have the IDE and Blink libraries all set up, we're ready to write some code and upload it to the NodeMCU. First of all, I'll open up the Arduino IDE and change some settings. I'll go to Tools, Port, and make sure an appropriate port is selected. In my case, it's COM4. And then I'll go to Tools, Board, and select NodeMCU as the board. And that's really all the settings we need to change. So now let's begin writing some code. Go to Files, Examples, scroll down, select Blink, Boards Wi-Fi, and click on ESP8266 Standalone. Now in this file, we only need to change 3 lines of code. The first line we'll have to change is this. I'll just replace this with the auth token I copied earlier. Now here, we'll have to write the name of Wi-Fi network we want our Node MCU to connect to, which in my case is the network. So here, I'll just type in the network. And for this field, we'll have to type in the password of Wi-Fi network. So in my case, the password for my Wi-Fi, the network, is ABCD1234. So I'll just type in ABCD1234. And that's it. That's literally all the code that we need to write. And now we're actually ready to upload this code to the Node MCU. So I'll directly hit upload and wait for it to process.
And it's done. The code has successfully been uploaded to the Node MCU, and the next time I power it on, it will automatically connect to my Wi-Fi network. And this concludes our step 2. Let's now move to step 3, hardware assembly.
Okay, so here's the plan. We'll connect the Node MCU and the relay board using some jumper cables. To power the Node MCU, we can either use a phone charger and directly plug it in, or we can use a power bank to power it up. To power the relay board, you can either use some batteries or get a breadboard power supply module. Now, the final step is to connect the electronical appliances with the relay board. You can directly pull out wires from your main socket and attach them to the relay, but to do so, I would recommend that you take help of a professional electrician and not to do it on your own, because working with such high voltages can be very dangerous and can cause some serious damage if you don't know what you're doing. So, for the sake of this tutorial, I would connect a simple external light bulb to one of the relays using a wire and connect the other end of that wire to the wall socket to supply power to the bulb. Simple enough, so let's get into it. Let's start by attaching the Node MCU to the breadboard. I'll connect the Node MCU with the relay board using some jumper cables. I'll connect digital pin D3 of the Node MCU to relay 1. Pin D4 to relay 2, D5 to relay 3, D6 to relay 4, and the ground pin of the Node MCU with the ground pin of the relay. I'll attach the light bulb to the relay board using this wire. I'll just screw the two open ends of the wire to the relay. To power the Node MCU, I'll use a smartphone charger. And now to power the relay, you should use some batteries or a breadboard power supply module, but currently I don't have any of those. So as a workaround, I'll power the relay using the Arduino board.
Which is wrong. You don't have to buy an Arduino board just to power the relay module. You can either use some batteries or a breadboard power supply module. But as I don't have any of those options, I'm using the Arduino board.
And now I'll attach the bulb to the wire. Finally, I'll plug both the smartphone charger connected to the Node MCU and the wire connected to the bulb to the power socket and turn them on.
Alright, let's now test this little setup of ours.
Before doing that, let's change one final setting in the Blink app. Open home automation project that we created earlier, and for each of the button, interchange the output from 0 to 1 to 1 to 0 and change the mode from push to switch. Repeat these steps for all the buttons. Alright, let's now hit the play button to test the project. And as you can see, the project is working just fine.
Alright, if this is what you wanted, to control your electronical appliances using your smartphone, then you're done. It's fine if you don't watch the rest of the video. But if you want to control your home appliances using your voice with voice commands, then do keep watching. And let's now move to step 4, configuring IFTTT.
Okay, so here is what we have done so far. To control home appliances over the internet, we are using NodeMCU, and to connect the home appliances with NodeMCU, we are using a relay board. So, the Blink app on our smartphone sends on or off commands to the NodeMCU, which turns on or off our home appliances. But this is not our goal. Our goal is to control the electrical appliances using Google Assistant's voice commands. Now, we can neither send Google Assistant's voice commands directly to the NodeMCU, nor can we send them directly to the Blink app. Therefore, we will use an intermediate tool called IFTTT, which will bridge the gap between Google Assistant and the Blink app. So, in the end, this is how things will work. When we say a voice command like turn on the light to Google Assistant, it will send that command to IFTTT. IFTTT will then interpret that command and send appropriate request to the Blink app. And in the end, Blink app sends the command to the NodeMCU and then to the electrical appliances. So let's get into it and configure IFTTT. First of all, I'll go to IFTTT.com and sign up to it using my Google account. Once I'm signed in, I'll click on My Applets and then click on New Applet. I'll click on this, search for Google Assistant and select it. I'll then click on Connect. At this point, IFTTT will ask you permission to use your Google account to add voice commands for Google Assistant, which I'll simply allow. And now we'll be presented with a screen with 4 options. I'll select the first one, which says say a simple phrase, which basically means that when I say a simple phrase to Google Assistant, then some work should happen. Now here we'll have to fill in the actual command that we say to the Google Assistant. So for the command, I'll type in turn on relay 1. Here we'll type some other way to say this previous command, which I'll just write as turn the first relay on. And once again, some other way to say the first command, something like turn on the first relay. Now here, I'll type the reply that the Google Assistant should respond with for the above phrase, something like okay, turning on relay 1. Once this is all done, I'll click on create trigger. As you can now see, we have successfully created a trigger, which means that if Google Assistant gets the command turn on relay 1, then something should happen, which in our case is sending a request to the Blink app to turn on relay 1. So to program this, I'll click on that. Now here I'll type webhooks and select it and then hit connect. Now webhooks is a tool that will allow us to send web requests to the Blink app. So to create a new web request, I'll click here. Now in this web page, for the URL field, you must type in this URL. This is the URL for the Blink server of India, but it should work for other places as well. Now after the forward slash, you must type the auth token of your Blink's project that you received in the mail. Now here, you must specify the digital pin of NodeMCU that you want to control. In our case, as we want to control relay 1, which is connected to digital pin D3 of NodeMCU, I'll type in D3. But we cannot write D3 here, because when Blink server sends the command to the NodeMCU, it assumes that it is sending the command to an Arduino board instead of a NodeMCU. So in this field, we'll write the digital pin of Arduino, which corresponds to the digital pin of NodeMCU. And as you can see from this diagram, the digital pin D3 of NodeMCU corresponds to pin D0 of Arduino. So here, we'll write D0. Now that this is done, we'll select the method as put content type as application/json, and for the body I'll write 0 in double quotes and inside square brackets. Here 0 means to turn on, so basically we're sending blink and request to turn on digital pin D3. Click on create action and finish. So similarly, I'll create another applet to turn off the relay. So I'll again click on my applet, select new applet, click this, search for Google Assistant and select it. Select say a simple phrase, and for the phrase I'll use turn off relay 1. And as a reply I'll type OK turning off relay 1 and hit create trigger. Now for the that part, I'll again search for webhooks and select it and follow the same steps as I did earlier. But this time in the body, instead of 0, I'll type in 1. I'll finally click on create action and finish. And as you can now see, we have two applets to turn on and off relay 1. And we have finally completed all the steps. So let's test it out.
Hey Google, turn on relay 1.
Okay, turning on relay 1.
Hey Google, turn off relay 1.
Okay, turning off relay 1.
And that's it for this video guys. If you like this video, do hit the like button, share this video with your friends, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.